But I'm married now, so I don't date much anymore. And I love my wife. You got married a year and a half ago, by God. She still has that new wife smell to her. I tell you, it's real nice. Yeah, I love her today. She can't cook, though. Good Lord. You know, we have the same thing every night. Nausea. All right. I get her meatloaf was on Fear Factor last year. All right. But I do like being married because that means I ain't got to buy condoms no more. And that gets me embarrassing buying rubbers when you're in your 40s, all right? It ain't like it used to be. It's embarrassing. They got all different shapes and sizes and colors. You don't want to get ripped off, so you got to try them on at the register there to get something you like, you know? Good Lord, you get one too small, you got to use a wiener horn they got up there. It don't fit. Doggone it, that went right in your chili dog. I apologize to you. Doggone it, Reverend, I apologize to you. That's why I used to buy lambskin rubbers. They was easy. Two sizes, Woolly Bully and Little Bo Peep. I like it. But my wife and I just had a baby 3 months ago. We pretty excited about that. It's something else, boy. At first, I didn't even realize she was pregnant, to be honest with you. You know, I'd kind of gotten used to her throwing up every time we had sex, you know. We did that home pregnancy test. You ever do that where you stick that piece of paper in and then you pull her out and if it's blue, you're screwed, you know what I mean? The bluer it is, the more screwed you is. I ain't saying it was blue, but I pulled it out and it was singing B.B. King tunes, all right? It was blue. She was worried about childbirth, too, because she's little, you know, and she's all scared. She's like, when I have this kid, I want to be knocked out and unconscious. I'm like, that's how you were when you got pregnant. That's full circle right there. I did feel bad. That's tough. I'm telling you, I felt horrible for her, just pushing and sweating and screaming at the top of her lungs and pushing and sweating, biting down on a stick. Now she knows how I feel after a couple of Hot Pockets. You ever eat them Hot Pockets? Good Lord. I was backed up like a urinal on St. Patrick's Day after eating them damn things. It was embarrassing. She's in the bed giving me, I'm in the toilet next to her, you know. I'm like, I need another epidural in here if you got one. My mom's like, how's the baby? Oh, he's fine. I had a C-section, though. All right. Well, he's a cute kid, boy. We already sold his pictures to Bass Pro Shop for $300. All right. You learn a lot, though, when you have kids. I'll tell you what. Did you know when a baby poops its diaper, you're not supposed to hit them with a rolled-up newspaper?
It's true. It's true.
They say, I was reading this one article, and it said, if you put on classical music in the crib when the toddler's sleeping, that he may grow up to be a scientist. You got a good shot at it. So I went home after I read that and popped an Alan Jackson CD in the crib. And hopefully when he grows up, he'll be able to fix my frickin' truck. All right. Yeah, but he's a cute kid, though. We're doing the breastfeeding, that's what we doing, breastfeeding. You haven't done that? I'm not. I dried up a week into it, all right? But my wife's doing it. I just got the cabbage off my nipples a while back. He irritates me sometimes when he breastfeeds. He's on the nipple, he's off the nipple, he's back on it, he's over here, he's looking up. I'm like, look, act like you've been there, all right? Good Lord. His name's Wyatt, after his grandma. Any of you fellas ever taste your wife's breast milk? Come on, get out of here. You know, I got to tell you, it ain't bad. All right, I got to tell you. It's a lot better than that crappy Slim Fast, I'll tell you that much. Matter of fact, that's what I'm doing to lose weight. Two titties in the morning and a sensible dinner. All right, that's what I'm doing. That's it. You're done. That's what I'm doing.